What a consignment shop is. Can you give us a brief overview of what it is and what it isn't?
Okay. So what it isn't is it's not really a yard sale inside.
Okay.
It's not a thrift store. It's kind of like a resale shop, but there's one major difference. And basically with consignment stores, you get paid for your items when they sell. Most of the time, resale shops, they buy the clothing up front from you, and then that's kind of what you get. You don't get a percentage of what it sells.
Okay.
With consignment, you get anywhere from 60% to about 40% of what your items sell for.
Okay, so that's good to know. So we're not thrift store, we're not bartering, we're not bargaining, we're not saying, oh, could you take 50 cents off of this?
It's yep.
The price is what it is.
Yes.
And as a consignment shop owner, what do you look for in a garment or a piece as it comes in? You're pretty particular about your pieces that come in.
Yes.
What are you looking for?
It has to be in like new condition. It still needs to be current in style and on trend. Our guideline is 2 years or newer.
Okay.
We do sometimes take things that are a little bit older than that because it's still in style.
Okay.
A denim jacket is always going to be in style. So skinny jeans, things like that. We also look for really unique pieces. We always get in these really fun jacket, blazer type jackets.
Yeah.
And they go out the door
okay,
so quickly.
Oh, that is great. So what about the pieces that come in? What are you looking for? You said, Within 2 years, like new condition, should I be dry cleaning my stuff before I come in? Is it necessary?
Well, we do ask that everything is freshly laundered.
Okay.
And your shoes, they need to be sanitized and cleaned before they come in. We usually do it with the shoes. It's easy for us to sanitize them again before we put them out.
Okay.
But the clothing really needs to make sure it's clean. It doesn't have dog hair on it. It has all the buttons. It has all the tags. That kind of thing.
You should have this like mental checklist you're going through as you're leaving the house to bring your stuff in
right.
for a consignment. And this is not just here at My Girlfriend's Wardrobe. This is kind of across the board
yes.
in a consignment shop.
Yep.
And I'm sure there's some consigners who have different, they may have less than 2 year regulations. They're like, only the past 6 months, we're only going to do that.
Yes, some do. Some are really, really picky. So some consignment stores want you to bring your stuff in on hangers. Others want them to be folded. With us, we prefer them folded, but if you bring them in on hangers, we're not going to make you unhang them and okay. fold them and put them in a bin.
Okay. So that's good to know. So for someone who is wanting to consign and bring things in, what could they do ahead of time to get the most money out of their piece? Because you said they're going to get 40 to 60% of whatever you decide to sell it for.
Yes.
With the, as a consignor, could I say, could you try selling this shirt for $10 or $20? Or do you try and steer people away from setting their own prices to try and get a higher percentage?
We try and steer people away from that. The only people that we really work with on price is people that have premium designer items.
Okay.
So if they bring in a Chanel bag, we will give them 24 hours to approve the price. We'll email it to them. And then if they don't get back to us within that 24 hours, that's what we put it out for.
Okay.
But if they get back to us within that time frame, we can kind of go, okay, well, this is what the current market value is. This is what they're selling for in other stores or on other websites. And we kind of go back and forth a little bit. Most of the time, we pick the best price, and everybody's okay with it.
Okay.
So if you bring in a shirt from Gap, we're going to price it and put it out right away.
Okay.
Because we know what our customers are willing to spend, and we know what the current market value is. So we're making sure that everybody's getting a pretty fair price.
So that's where the fee that I'm paying for you to sell my piece for goes to. It goes towards your education and your knowledge of the market.
Yes.
So that's where that fee
yep.
is going to. Speaking of fees, when someone is choosing a consignment shop, what are fees that they should be aware of? Is there a drop-off fee? Is there a pickup fee? Is there a launder fee? Is there a percentage of the item? Well, we had said the 40 to 60%, mm-hmm. depending. So what are some things people should be aware of?
Some stores do charge fees to consign with them.
Okay.
Sometimes it's every time you drop off, sometimes it's every season, sometimes it's once a year. We don't charge anything like that. So you can come in, you create an account with us, it's free. we just take our percentage.
Okay.
We keep items for 90 days. So if you pull them early, there is an early pull fee,
okay,
just because we've put all the time into making sure it's presentable, it's taking up space on our racks, we've tagged it, we've used our supplies and our time and manpower to do it.
Yeah, you have a vested interest in that piece.
Yes. Yep. So we ask that you leave everything here for the 90-day minimum. Sometimes we extend things. It just depends on what it is. If we're running low on something, we'll try and keep as much in that size as possible until we can kind of go through and get some more new items in, and then we'll go and pull the older items.
So what about an end of season? Do you run an end of season sale where you mark down your whatever piece has to be by 20% or 30%, and then what happens to that percentage? Does that come off? Do you and the consignor split that loss in percentage, or do you take it? Do they take it? How does that work?
Well, if somebody brings something in and their item sells for 50% off, they would get half of the 50% off price.
Okay.
So it's kind of split because they're getting less, but we're also getting less.
Okay.
So because of that, we actually offer a higher percentage. If your items sell in the first 30 days, you get 60% of what it sells for.
Oh,
regardless
wow.
if it's a premium designer item or not.
Okay.
After those 30 days, then your item, you'll get 50%. And if you consign your premium designer items with us, you get 60% for the full 90 days.
That's
so we offer a little bit more in the beginning because we know that not everything's going to sell in the first 30 days. In a perfect world, it would.
Yeah.
But sometimes pieces have to wait a little bit for their new owners to come in and find them.
That's great. I know I've shopped here before, and you're great with helping me. You're like, oh, you might like this, or oh, try that, or I'll come in with an idea. I'm like, I'm looking for an orange dress with a ruffle, and you'll say, well, I don't have that, but I could try this, and that's a great way of connecting with your customer, and I appreciate that.
Yes, I like doing that. It's a lot of fun. I like helping people come in when they're going to an event or they're going on a trip, and they need an outfit, and I like helping them find something that, they're comfortable in. It makes them feel good. And then they go on their trip, and they come back, and they get to show me pictures and tell me what they did. And it's fun for me. I don't usually get to go on vacation often.
Yeah.
So I live through my customers.
That's great. Now, for someone who is looking to save, I mean, when you come to a consignment shop, you are getting a lot of times premium quality items for a lower than ticketed price at the retail store. Are there ways that people could save even more? Maybe shop an end of a season sale or a coupon?
Yep, we have frequent shopper cards.
Okay.
So you get a punch for every 25 you spend, and then on your 10th purchase, you actually get a discount. We also do wardrobe cash. So when you come in, if you spend $50 or more, you get $10 off. We only do those during a certain time, and then they're redeemable during a certain time. And then we have our end of season sales. So when we're making our big transition from winter to spring, we'll have a 50% off the winter items.
Okay.
And then, summer into fall, it's a big 50% off sale. And sometimes in between fall to winter, we'll do little 20% off sales, kind of like what we're doing now.
Okay.
So there's always ways to save.
And tell me about your authentic bags. I love you have this program where if you have a knockoff bag, you bring it in and you're able to put that price towards a tell me about your knockoff bag.
So it's called it's called our Destroy and Shop program.
Okay.
And you can bring in your fake bag and you get a $10 store credit.
Okay.
So that's $10 that you can put towards buying an authentic bag or, clothing in your closet, whichever you prefer. Knockoffs are illegal and it really, really hurts the industry. It hurts other consignment stores. It hurts people who spent, $1,000 on a handbag. And they bring it into a consignment store, and the value of it kind of diminishes because there's so many knockoffs. And I think Coach, they're crazy for going after these people. They will do it, no problem. And they've filed over 650 lawsuits, and they actually won one against a mom and daughter. They won $44 million.
Oh my goodness!
So it's a big deal.
It is,
and it's something that really, really bothers me. And so we launched this program actually during Boutique Week.
Okay.
This year, and so far we've had a great response, and we've had so many fake bags come in, and we cut them up, and then sometimes we'll make videos or we put them around the store to kind of educate people. You can spend $50 and get a fake bag, but it's going to be made with cardboard, and it's going to be made with the stuff that goes under your carpet to make your carpet soft when you're walking on it. It's not made with the highest quality materials, and also when you pull them apart, you'd see how disgusting everything is.
What it is,
It's not good. It's not something that you want in your house at all.
Yeah, if you're going to invest in a piece, you really need to invest in a quality piece.
Yes.
And I'm all about that, investing in quality pieces. So tell us about, we are in My Girlfriend's Wardrobe. We're here in York, Pennsylvania. Where can we find you on the web? You also have a web store, don't you?
Yes, we have an online store as well. That's actually how we started.
Okay.
So we started out with our online store, and it was actually my internship for college.
Wow.
Because that's what happens when you can't find an internship.
Yeah, you make your own.
So we started out with our online store, and we kind of planned it so when we expanded, it could also be my junior project for college and also my senior project.
Wow, okay.
So we expanded from the online store to a mobile store.
Okay.
And from the less than a year later after the mobile store, we opened our first storefront, which was up at North George.
Now, you just said mobile store. Explain what a mobile store is.
So we actually took a camper. It's 30 feet long, and I think it's 10 foot wide.
Okay.
It's about 500 square feet, and we turned it into a store. Wow. So you could actually walk in, and you could shop. We turned the bathroom into a fitting room. The bedroom area was our women's section. We had a sale area. Shoes, purses, and jewelry were all up front.
Wow.
So it's a little big for us now.
Yeah.
You know, we started that 6 months after we launched our website.
Okay.
And we were just growing so fast. We have consigners from 25 different states.
Okay.
So we get stuff shipped into us all the time. And it just became so much to manage. And my closet became, this, you know, MGW's inventory room.
Yeah.
Not my closet anymore.
No.
And I have a lot of clothes, so I needed space. And that's when we came up with the mobile store. And we did that. And then when we opened the storefront, we went from 500 square feet to 1,200 square feet. And now we just recently moved to our newest location down on Market Street. And now we have about 4,000 square feet total. We have our basement, which is where our offices are. And then we have our floor where all the selling is.
So you don't just pull from the local area. You say you have 25 different states people will send you items.
Yep. As we also have a new consigner from Canada now as well.
Wonderful.
So we're getting stuff in from out of the country too.
So how does that work? Do they email you something and you say, yes, I'll take it? Or do they send it hoping you'll take it?
They actually email us asking for a label.
Okay.
And we send them a prepaid USPS label.
Okay.
And they get it in their email. They print it out, tape it to their box.
Okay.
And they either drop it off at the post office or they schedule a pickup.
Okay.
So we don't know what we're getting.
Okay.
So it's, you know, it's just like when people bring items in locally. We have no idea what's walking through our door. It could be a Chanel bag. It could be UGG boots. It could be, you know, a whole bunch of awesome Gap tops. We have no idea at all.
So what happens when you get those items from California and they send you 15 items and you like six of them, you're able to use six of them, what happens to the others? Do you ship them back? Does the consigner pay to have them shipped back to them?
They can pay to have them shipped back, but we usually donate them.
Okay.
So with our out-of-state consigners, just because we've gotten so big and it costs crazy amounts of money to ship things back when they send us that might be stained or might have a hole in it that they missed.
Mm-hmm.
So our new policy is that everything has to get donated.
Okay.
If they want something back, they're more than willing, you know, to email us and we can send them an invoice. The only exception to that rule is, again, premium designer items.
Okay.
Yeah. Usually those sell, though.
Yeah.
So we really don't have to worry about those.
Yeah, your premium line is constantly changing. Every time I come here, I'm like, that's new, and that's new, and that's new. So that those are great. So tell us, we are in My Girlfriend's Wardrobe in York, Pennsylvania. Where can we find you online?
We're online on our website. It's mygirlfriendswardrobe.net.
Okay.
We're also on Facebook. Our Twitter handle is MGW Online.
Okay.
My Girlfriend's Wardrobe was too long.
Yes.
We're also on Instagram, Google Plus, Foursquare, pretty much all of them, Pinterest.
Okay. Yeah. And guys, don't worry about anything. I will have all that information in the comments below. You guys can click over and maybe consign some things here at My Girlfriend's Wardrobe. Alexandria, thank you so much for having us here.
Thank you.
And for sharing your two cents on consignment.